Hello, and welcome back to Scram Mechanic. In this video, I'm going to show how to make an independent suspension with realistic steering. In the last video I uploaded was with this one, and I had an issue where I would steer and the suspension would flatten out. But I fixed it. Right after I uploaded the video, actually, is when I managed to get it working again. So yeah. If you haven't seen it yet, I have a video on how to make this suspension here. So you might want to go watch that and build that and then come back. So, what I'm going to do is set up my inventory how I like it really. Or not my inventory, my hotbar. I really should have done this before recording. I always cut it out, but I'm too lazy. And OBS needs a pause recording button, so I'll just stop. So, seats go. Piston. And engine. There we go. Okay. So, once you've got this, the front suspension, basically from the left side of the screen over, what you need to do, what you need to do is cut off the upper arm. That sounds kind of gruesome. Remove the upper arms. Sounds a bit better. Now, the reason we have to remove the upper arms is so there is enough room to put steering on the knuckles or pubs, whatever you want to call them. So, all I've done is removed the upper arm. Actually, do I have control? Suspension from that video. Don't think so. No, I do not. Okay. So, once the upper arms are off, you want to take T. Oops. You also want to get rid of the bearings on here, too. Take a T, put it facing forwards, or back. It doesn't really matter, but in real life, these buggies have it to the front. And then you put your upper arm back on. So I'll just do that right quick. Thank you. There we go. So all I've done is move the upper arm up. Now. I can't remember if I changed that or not. So I did not. Really? Not that hit? It does. I don't know. Anyways. And then now we take Baron. I'm going to switch bearings so you can see what I'm doing. The bearing there. Then a pipe. And then I use a version of a U-joint that I have. And stick that on here. Except I did that wrong. Did I do that before? I do not remember. Okay. Yeah, this is on the wrong side. So you want the arm, an arm coming down, and then out. So I need this one. There we go. So you want it like this. I don't know. Then I need to move this as well. Middle of your tie rod. You want this to be the same length, excuse me, the same length as your A-arms. So you want your pivots to be in the same pivot for your wheel, and then same up here on the chassis. So now, I'm going to weld this one on real quick. So, in the video, the issue was right here. You can see that bearing. I forgot that. It goes right there. And that bearing fixed the issue I was having. Not sure why, but it did. Okay. So now, remove these. If we don't remove those, these won't weld into position. I think we need to get rid of these bearings as well. So, this part, if you look at this, there's a bearing here and here. You want this end to also be pointing down. Yes. That should be okay. And we do the same on this side. Down and over. Okay. And I believe, let's put a U-joint on there, or not a U-joint, a T on there, And then bearing, I forgot all the panels. Is it? Okay. Okay. So bring this back a couple. The length of this part will determine your steering lock. Find a total of 3 blocks long to work the best in this situation. There we go. And that is that basically done. I am now just going to put these back on. If you don't take it off the lift to put those back on, they will stick to the bearings on here, and it won't work right. Weld it. Remove the steering from there. Put it up here and reverse that one. Ow. I did that wrong. It appears it did not need to be reversed. But there you go. It now works. And it doesn't have the issue that I had before. Is how to make realistic independent suspension with steering. I hope this helps. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching.